friends, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Carolyn, if you're new here, and in today's video, I wanted to talk about my minimalism journey. But before I get started, I wanted to give a huge shout out to my friend Michelle because she inspired me to make this video today because I was just feeling so stuck in like a YouTube rut. Constantly uploading once a week for 2 months is really difficult, especially when you have a full-time job. I'm honestly super thankful that she reminded me of the why I make videos. It's just, you know, videos that make me happy, that I enjoy making and enjoy editing. So you should definitely check her out. She's really funny. Her personality is great. She's just a great person to be around, honestly. And she does a lot of arts and crafts, like sustainability, thrifting, all that good stuff, DIYs. So I'm gonna link her YouTube channel in the description box below. So please check her out and let's get on with the video. I think the first thing I wanted to talk about was that growing up, I always had an obsession. And I know that sounds a little scary, but it's true. I don't really know where it stems from, but like if I liked something, like I would just be really obsessed. So for example, when I was younger, I used to hoard travel guides because I was like, oh, I'm gonna travel everywhere. And when I mean hoard travel guides, so I live in the US and like every state like would send free travel guides. And so I would literally just like sign up for all these physical mailers that they could send you, be like, oh, I'm gonna travel here one day, and just like I just really got into it to the point that it was getting out of control. But then I like came to the sudden realization that, you know, I'm probably gonna end up going here in the future. So slowly I was able to like let go of these travel guides and recycle them. But then I fell into like another obsession, which was buying fast fashion. And I feel like this was such a thing back when I was in high school because people were obsessed, at least in like middle school or high school, people were obsessed with having like those Aeropostale jackets or Hollister jackets that had like the name plastered across the front. Like, you guys know what I'm talking about. And I feel like I always kept trying to buy clothes because I kept trying to fit in high school. Like, I used to do this dumb thing in middle school where like I had these really close family friends who gifted me like Aeropostale and Hollister shirts, and I wore nothing but Aeropostale and Hollister shirts because I was like, I want to look cool, I want to fit in middle school, and it was just really dumb. But like, I was like getting to this point where I was buying all these clothes because I was like, oh, I'm gonna wear it. And I would see other people at school wear it, and I'd be like, okay, I'm gonna wear this. Like, I'm gonna get into this. And I'd buy all these clothes, and I ended up like never wearing it. But luckily last year I was able to donate so many of those. But it's like, it's such a waste of money. Like, you buy all these clothes and then they sit in your closet for years and then you never ever wear them. And that is like so bad because like that's such a waste, you know. You could have just saved all that money and then bought something that you really enjoyed. Moving on, in high school, like later in high school, I got really obsessed with nail polish because I had a friend. She would screenshot like all these really cool nail designs, and I just like went ham. I would screenshot so many nail polish designs from Instagram, and it got to this point that my whole photo reel was just screenshots of nail photos, which I was like, what the heck? Like, I like had like one shoebox of nail polish before college, and then I ended up out of college with like 10 shoeboxes full of nail polish. And like, my roommates know this, like, it got so out of control, especially when I went to college, because I had my own money that I've been saving throughout high school, but then I had no one to just be like, oh, like, you shouldn't be buying this nail polish, you shouldn't be buying like clothes that you don't wear. I'd be like, oh, but it's on sale. So like, I'd try and justify it for myself. If I had a bad week at college, like if I didn't do well on a test or something, I would just like go to Ulta and I'd be like, oh, well, I think it's time to treat myself. And so like, I went down further and further down this rabbit hole. It was really bad. Yep, the hair that's gonna bother me during editing. Around like middle of college, I saw a bunch of friends and they were all like wearing makeup, and so I was kind of like, well, now I should get into makeup. And so I felt like hard into makeup. Instead of buying all this nail polish, I was like, okay, I'm gonna buy makeup now. And so I basically ended up hoarding like so much stuff. And honestly, I feel like this also has to do with Asian parents and them hoarding a lot of stuff. Now I like regret it because I'm like, oh man, like I wish I didn't have all these things. But luckily, I'm trying to sell a bunch of stuff on Mercari. So I will leave my Mercari link down below if you're interested in purchasing anything. It was literally consuming me. This shopping habit was consuming me. I feel like it just got so bad to a point where I couldn't even keep track of what I was buying. I would just buy a nail polish or a lip color or a highlighter, and then all of a sudden I have like 20 highlighters, and like it takes 2 or 3 years to finish a highlighter. So I basically have enough highlighters for my lifetime. Luckily, I was able to learn about what minimalism is and be more intentional about my purchases. And I would have to say that the person that really helped inspire me with minimalism is Matt D'Avella. I'll also link his channel in the description box down below. Basically, he helped me look at the things I had, and it helped me realize that there's just so much more to life than things. I think that was when the light bulb went off in my head, when I was like, oh man, like I don't even remember like most of these things that I purchased. Also, it's just like when I move out of my parents' house, it's gonna be so hard because I used to like drag all my like makeup and nail polish like back and forth to college and home. I end up only using maybe like 10 nail polishes throughout the year and like the same makeup items that I would typically always use every day, but it was just definitely like a security blanket. I don't remember which video exactly was the one that got me started into minimalism, but I remember he made a video about Black Friday and how people are just so obsessed with consumerism. I'm honestly really grateful for him because now I'm a lot more intentional with my purchases. Like for example, if I buy something, I kind of give myself like a certain time frame to use it or to wear it, and then if I don't use it or wear it within that time frame, then I will go return it. Because if I don't get excited about wearing a piece of clothing that I just bought, then I'm probably not gonna wear it. Like if I choose other things over it, then I'm not gonna wear it. And I feel like that's like really important, because you should be buying and using things that you're really excited about or things that you actually need. Like looking back and seeing how obsessed I was, it's a little scary actually. I remember back like during the YouTube makeup series when it was like 2015 to 2017, where everyone was so obsessed with buying makeup. They were so obsessed with all these new releases, makeup brands basically kept coming out with so much new stuff, and it made you feel like you needed to jump on that liquid matte lipstick trend, which I just don't even like, but I own a bunch because, you know, YouTube made me buy it kind of thing. It's been a long journey, and I'm really proud of myself for getting this far. Hopefully I will just be able to continue this path and this journey. And I've been trying to inspire other people with minimalism because I don't think we need that many things. I feel like America is just so used to like consumerism. We just buy like way more than we need to. But another thing I also wanted to touch upon before I end this video is Marie Kondo. I feel like I love the Marie Kondo method because it gets you to declutter your house and clean things up, and it makes you feel better about everything. But at the same time, I think a lot about the environment and landfills and how things are just so overflowing, you know? I feel like Marie Kondo is so cute. I just watched one of her episodes for the first time the other day, but like so much of the things that we get rid of end up in landfills. Like, we're so lucky in America when we throw something away, like we don't see it after that. But I feel like other countries like suffer, our landfills suffer, our environment suffers. And so I feel like it's better to try and resell things, give them away on your local Buy Nothing Facebook groups. Like instead of just like going to Goodwill and donating things, which I'm not actually sure if this is true, but I heard that Goodwill basically throws away a lot of the stuff that they get as donations to the landfills anyways, which I'm just like, it makes you feel like you're doing something good because you're like, oh, I'm gonna donate to Goodwill so that they can resell it. But if they end up throwing away a lot of things and going to the landfill, then it's like, oh, there's all this environmental impact. We need to take better care of our environment, and our environment will thank us for it down the line. One more thing that I want to touch upon was like how my buying habits are now. So I looked back at like my material items and what I've bought this year, and so far I've only bought a couple pieces of clothing that I wear all the time, and my new iPhone, a new wallet, a lot of things that I feel like I'm going to be using every day, like skincare. So I'm definitely a lot more intentional about my purchases, and I'm really happy about that. Hopefully we'll be able to normalize like reusing, reselling, giving, gifting to people instead of just throwing things directly in the landfill and constantly buying new things. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and then comment down below what you think I should film next. I might do a how my experience selling on Mercari is, because I've been obsessed with selling on Mercari lately, so maybe some tips and tricks for that. If you haven't already, please subscribe and ring the bell if you want to get notified of my future videos. All right, bye guys.